economic development in Greater Reading on BCTV is supported by Fulton Bank.
Welcome to Economic Development in Greater Reading. I'm Deb Hefner from Burke's Economic Partnership. Today we're going to be talking about the Kutztown region. When most of us think about Kutztown, we think about Kutztown University and the Pennsylvania German Festival. Today we're going to show you some of the innovations and technologies that Kutztown University has implemented in order to prepare the workforce of tomorrow. We're also going to talk about the small businesses located in downtown Kutztown and about the Keystone Innovation Zone. The Keystone Innovation Zone, commonly known as KIZ, is an incentive program that's offered by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, and it's geared to assist innovative startup companies become successful. Today's guest is Jeff Brace, the Executive Director and Main Street Manager for Kutztown Community Partnership. Welcome, Jeff.
Pleasure, Deb.
Kutztown University currently has over 10,000 students enrolled. Over the past 5 years, they've made significant capital and technology investments in order to meet the demands of their growing student body and for the workforce of tomorrow. I recently visited the home of the Golden Bears. Could you please roll that tape? One of the areas which Kutztown University has invested heavily in is their science college. 6 years ago, they built the BAME Science Center and equipped it with the latest technology in order to prepare their students for the workplace of tomorrow. That technology is what we are currently viewing. We at Burke's Economic Partnership know that workforce readiness is one of the first questions which companies ask when they're considering locating a new facility in Greater Reading. Therefore, our colleges and universities are invaluable in our ability to grow jobs in Berks County. Future capital improvements planned at Kutztown University include the renovation of the Schaefer Auditorium and the development of a master plan for their Pennsylvania German Cultural Heritage Center. The economic impact to the Kutztown region as a result of the university is $450 million annually. That impact clearly demonstrates that Kutztown University is the main economic driver in the Kutztown region. At Kutztown University. Has Kutztown implemented any new technology recently in the College of Education?
We are all smart classrooms. We've invested quite a bit in that, and we are really engaged in having our professors use the smart classrooms as part of their daily lessons, not just as demonstrations. I use a smart classroom in my faculty meetings.
And can you explain for our audience what makes a smart classroom?
It's the touch screen that you have with your smartphone, the iPhone, the BlackBerry, you know, those touch screens, iPad. The whole, what used to be the blackboard, which is now the whiteboard, is a giant touch screen. So you use that like you would your iPhone. You just touch whatever, you go to whatever site, you write on it, you can save that, unlike your iPhone. You can actually save what you've written to start mm-hmm. with the next class on. You can send that out to the students in the classroom. The next level that we want to go with is the smart board actually built into the lecturing, so that you can actually touch right from the lecturing and they'll be able to see it through the projectors.
Darrell, thank you for sharing the changes that Kutztown University has implemented in their College of Education.
Thank you for being at Kutztown University. It's a wonderful place to be.
Hi, I'm Dr. Bill Mauder, and I'm Dean of the College of Visual and Performing Arts at Kutztown University. In this building, which is the Sheridan Arts Building, which was recently renovated and expanded, this is where the visual arts are located. Art education has, of course, changed over the years, and one of the major things that our teachers need to know and to have is a facility with not just the usual things of ceramics and weaving and metalworking and art and color and all of that, but also, of course, digital facility. And one of the things that we did when we renovated this building was to add several rooms, new classrooms and studios for digital imaging and digital learning. One of the rooms here on this floor is really for communication design, which we have, again, about 350 students in communication design. And in the renovation of this building, we added two new digital classrooms for them so that they, when they get out, and they usually, students who graduate in communication design go into advertising, go into graphic design, go into illustration, and are people in great demand every year. They place a good number of their graduates out in industry because of the skills that they learned here. And what we try to do is to have them right at the cutting edge of that industry.
Hi, I'm here with Linda Day, the chair of the Computer Science Department at Kutztown University. Linda, I understand the students have been doing some very innovative things with a Roomba, which we all know is that little vacuum that does its own thing.
Yes, theirs don't do any vacuuming. They actually have computers attached that do vision things. They've been working with robotic vision. So the different students program their robots to recognize different things, whether it was black and white stripes or red colors. And so one of the groups that had the red colors there, they played bullfighting with it. So they'd put a red flag and the robot would go that way, and then they'd run with the flag a different way and the robot would follow them.
Excellent. And I also understand the students have developed a unique iPhone application.
Yeah, that's another professor with another student, and they have an iPhone application that will read you your text messages. So if you're busy doing something, occupied with something, and you get a text message, it will actually come verbally across to you.
So the computer science department here at Kutztown University is really teaching and challenging the students to think outside the box, to be innovative, to find solutions. You know, and at Burke's Economic Partnership, we're always working with companies that are looking for that innovative workforce. So it's good to hear that we're developing that right here in Berks County. So thank you, Linda.
Thank you.
I'm here with Dr. Phil Reed at the Planetarium. Let's go inside and take a look. Dr. Reed, I understand that Kutztown University recently did a significant investment in order to bring the software here.
Well, the software and the hardware combined, we invested about $65,000.
Okay. So you're using this to help educate the Kutztown University students, but also I understand you have local elementary schools and junior highs and high schools that come here?
That's right. We have our outreach program to the community consisting of free shows. That is, we have a schedule of shows that anybody can show up. But we also provide private shows for groups like school groups and scouting troops in the community.
Okay. And if someone is interested in coming here and learning about this and seeing your programs, how do they find out that schedule for the general public viewings?
Okay, we have a new website, kutztown.edu/planetarium.
Hi, my name is Carrie Gardy. I'm the director of the Career Development Center, and we work with local employers here to determine the skill sets that the students need upon graduation. We then take that information back to the faculty to prepare students so they are more competitive upon graduation.
Kutztown University is a natural segue to talk about the small businesses that are located in downtown Kutztown, as they're clearly impacted by the existence of KU. Jeff, the Kutztown Community Partnership was awarded a Main Street designation. Who awards that designation?
Our designation was awarded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. The Department of Community and Economic Development makes that designation. We had to go through a multi-year screening process and demonstrate the value of the state investing in Kutztown.
What guidelines are there for that program?
First, we had to demonstrate that there was a community plan in place, that this wasn't something that we were just going to wing it. We actually had to demonstrate that what we wanted to do, how we were going to do it. We had to do some market research to demonstrate the economic opportunities that existed, such as the university, the Keystone Innovation Zone, and how those assets would interact with the downtown. We also had to do some local fundraising to demonstrate that there was buy-in from merchants, from property owners, residents, and municipal government.
So what benefits are realized by the small businesses located in downtown Kutztown as a result of the Main Street designation?
number of benefits that we've been able to provide, not just to the business owners in downtown Kutztown, but also to the community as a whole. First, there's professional management of the downtown environment. When a vacant storefront opens, we try to fill it as quickly as possible with a potential tenant. Having a vacant storefront next to an existing business drives down some of the customer traffic, and we try to head that off as quickly as possible. So we also see increase in sales, increase in foot traffic, more customers coming into the downtown, higher property values for property owners and for the municipal tax base, and community marketing, whether it be through special events or through the branding and marketing campaigns that we undertake.
Great. We're going to now take a short BCTV commercial break.
You're watching Economic Development in Berks on bctv.org. Be informed. Be involved. Be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more local business information, go to bctv.org. Economic Development in Berks is supported by Fulton Bank. To find out how you and your business can support a program on BCTV, go to bctv.org.
Jeff, how can you help someone who's looking to start a new small business in Kutztown?
Well, my office oftentimes gets people walking in from the street indicating interest in starting a business in Kutztown. And that could be somebody with experience in running a business in the past. Maybe they have another location elsewhere. Or maybe it's an individual who has an idea or an entrepreneurial spirit that needs some support. First thing that we'll almost always do is talk to them about business planning. What kind of long-range plan do they have in place? Financing, do they have their own personal finances? Are they looking at investors? Have they talked to the Small Business Development Center? And then we'll start talking to them about site opportunities, how many square feet they need, what the options are in town, and how we can connect them to the property owners or to a real estate agent who might have a lead on some properties that we don't know about.
Okay. And then what things do you do to assist existing businesses in downtown Kutztown?
Well, we do this for existing businesses. There's some things that we'll do for an existing business and for a new business. We have a facade program that'll match dollar for dollar physical improvements to the storefront or the front of the building, whether it be signage or painting. We'll also provide some marketing assistance. We have a gift card program, very similar to any mall gift card or, you know, like a Walmart or Target gift card, where you purchase the gift card, and more than 30 business owners in town will accept that as payment. So that's a little benefit that we can offer to both new and existing business owners. We also offer parking management for employees and staff of businesses to get them off the street. Many of our properties don't have off-street parking, so we have a couple of central lots that we can lease to them. And we have a customer-friendly parking program along our Main Street area to help ease the tensions of a two-hour parking situation. So if anybody is looking to shop in Kutztown, make sure you ask the business owners for the parking pass so you don't get a ticket.
Okay. You know what? The gift card I was not aware of. I'm going to have to get some of those because my oldest son is a student at Kutztown University, and that
Great.
Would come in very handy for him as he's shopping and eating along downtown Kutztown.
Absolutely. It's great to have the gift card because you can use it for coffee, pizza, haircuts. A lot of the retailers accept it. It really is a fabulous gift for Kutztown University students.
It's a great idea.
We sell that online, incidentally.
I will be checking that out later today.
Cool.
Liquid Interactive is one of the four companies that are located in the Kutztown node of the Greater Reading Keystone Innovation Zone. Let's go to the tape, please, of our visit to Liquid Interactive. I'm here at Tech Park with Jim Ludlow, the president and CEO of Liquid Interactive.
Hi.
Thank you for having us today, Jim.
Oh, well, thank you. We're very honored to be here and part of your program. Can you tell our viewers about Liquid, when you started, what kind of services you offer?
Yeah, I'd be glad to. Liquid Interactive is a four-year-old company. We just celebrated our fourth anniversary on November 1st, and we've been located here for almost that entire time in Tech Park in Brunningsville. And Kutztown University is our landlord, and we're part of the Keystone Innovation Zone program out of Harrisburg and administered out of Reading. Mm-hmm. We're very pleased with that. A little bit about interactive marketing firms, which is technically what Liquid is considered, is marketing moved into the internet era permanently about 10 years ago, and it's been increasing steadily.
So what type of services in particular do you provide to your clients?
We will design and build a website. We will design and build the technology that supports the website. We will do analytics, search engine optimization programs. We'll do traffic analysis. We will study, come up with programs to drive traffic and campaigns to drive traffic to the website. And we'll do things, and also a big growing area for us, besides the social media marketing, which I think everybody is very familiar with, but the big move and shift, logically, is the move to mobile marketing. And that's just an extension, it's just another delivery mechanism for internet marketing, interactive marketing.
So you would help customers take their website and make sure that it's compatible when somebody pulls out their iPhone and wants to look up their services?
Exactly. Yeah. Okay. There's most websites are really not compatible, fully compatible to be viewed on a mobile device.
Jim, you mentioned that you're located in a Keystone Innovation mm-hmm. Zone, which is a program that's run by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, mm-hmm. and it is geared to help startup companies such as Liquid Interactive. There's a lot of benefits to being in a Keystone Innovation Zone, and I know you work very closely with Jennifer Leinbach, who administers the Berks County Innovation mm-hmm. Zone, and she's located at the Chamber of Commerce and Industry in Greater Reading. Jim, as you had mentioned to me earlier, one of the things that you really like about the Keystone Innovation Zone program is that it is almost award-based. You have to meet certain benchmarks and can show that you're continuing to grow your company. And when that happens, there are segments and benefits that the Keystone Innovation Zone can offer you in order to help continue to grow your company. Your internship program is one aspect of mm-hmm. that. So you bring in interns from any university or mm-hmm. college that you would like. I know you mentioned that Kutztown has been a very good feeder program
yes.
for you. You bring them in, they're successful, they've helped you grow your company, and at the end of the internship, after you've paid them for their services, you can be awarded a partial scholarship to help offset that cost so that you can continue to develop interns.
That's correct.
And you've seen a very good success ratio of moving from an intern into a full-time employee?
Yes. It's an outstanding program, and it's very good for the community. It's very good for the students and the curriculum. We did hire, just recently, hire a full-time Kutztown graduate who was an intern for us for the past year or so, and I expect that to continue.
And I understand that Liquid was mm-hmm. the recipient of a micro grant. Mm-hmm. Can you talk about what you used that funding for?
The micro grant is, again, they're just small reimbursements or scholarships, as you aptly said, to help defray the cost of getting certification. Say, we're a Microsoft Gold Certified Partner, And so every year to maintain that, we have to invest in training, we have to invest in certification activities and related events. And so working with the KIZ program and Jennifer, we're able to, after an employee successfully completes the certification, we're able to get a partial scholarship or reward for that effort.
Can you explain the tax credit benefit of being in a Keystone Innovation Zone?
I'll do my best. If I'm able to increase jobs, that's increasing my wages that I pay, that's increases the payroll taxes I pay. So if I'm able to achieve the success standards that the KIZ program has, I get a rebate of a partial rebate of the tax credits, which I get to reinvest in the business for working capital purposes and continue growth. Mm-hmm. So it's been very successful, very happy with it.
Okay. I was actually going to ask you what advice you would give to a new company located in a KIZ zone, and I think you already said it very clearly there. You know, that know the program, work the program, meet your benchmarks. So, you know, get in touch with your KIZ coordinator and understand what's out there that can help your business grow. So, what's next for Liquid Interactive?
Well, we have been faring well through the recession, and it's been tough, just like it has been for everybody else, I think. But we have managed to grow. We've grown 33% this year. We just were able to hire 2 full-time employees from this area. And we've also added many new clients from this area and then also out of the area, you know, from Boston to North Carolina. So we're very proud of our accomplishments so far in 2010. And our goal is to continue building that head of steam in 2011 and beyond.
Thank you for having us today, Jim.
Oh, well, thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Jeff, can you share some of the success stories of Kutztown Community Partnership?
Certainly. We've had a very busy year. I've been with the Kutztown Community Partnership for a little over a year now. And in that time, we've managed to complete 23 facade projects, which has stimulated $150,000 in investment just in the fronts of buildings throughout the downtown. Total at this point in 2010, we're estimating about $1.5 million in private sector investment in the downtown. So there's a substantial amount of economic interest in the work that's happening there. In 2009, we estimated about $300,000 in investment. So we're looking at 2009 and 2010 at a time when economic growth and investment was not the norm, where that investment was very much part of our culture. In 2010, we've added a net of 6 new businesses, with many of them coming online right about now, actually. Combination of eateries and retail establishments. In January of 2011, we estimate that we'll have a total of 2 vacancies in the downtown available for rent. And they're smaller spaces that we would like to get filled, but when we have somewhere in the neighborhood of 85, 90 storefronts, and only 2 of them are vacant, we're feeling quite proud of the success that's taking place there.
That speaks volumes about your program, Jeff.
Yeah. In terms of job creation, we're estimating at this point of the year, we'll have more clear numbers as we head into the end of 2010, going into January and February. We're estimating in the neighborhood of 25 net new jobs created in downtown Kutztown. In hospitality, in food service, in retail sectors. So that's a good number of new jobs that have come into town. We've helped to remediate a couple of blighted properties that were on the verge of condemnation or foreclosure in some instances, matching the prospective property owners with the former property owners, and helping them to navigate the investment process. So that's going to yield us a couple of new businesses as well. You mentioned at the top of the show Kutztown University and the strength that it brings to the region. We've started to form some really solid partnerships with Kutztown University, with the off-campus advisory council, students who provide volunteers to help us with special events, who give us marketing ideas and help us run with those marketing ideas, including a marketing idea that we're probably going to roll out in early 2011 that utilizes texting for marketing with the college students, an opt-in kind of program. To our knowledge, there aren't any university towns that are utilizing it the way we're hoping to utilize it. So it might be a first of its kind innovation in the Commonwealth.
You know, we have found at Burke's Economic Partnership, we use interns. And, you know, having those college students help you, you know, they bring you the cutting edge, latest technology because they know it and they're using it.
Yep.
And just a breath of fresh air and new energy. So that's great that you're incorporating them into your marketing plans for the region. That's
absolutely
excellent.
Some of the other accomplishments, we managed to get feature articles in Pennsylvania Magazine, which is a tourism magazine, mm-hmm. and also Pursuits, the state's tourism publication. So we're starting to get a recognition that our community is a good place to come and spend some time to do some shopping. We're starting to look at how we can market our community outside of the region, recognizing that Kutztown sits at an interesting fulcrum between Allentown and Reading, that there's an untapped market that we have access to.
Great. I'd like to thank our guest, Jeff Brace, for joining me today, as well as Liquid Interactive and Kutztown University for being our video guest. And I'd like to thank you for taking a ride with us.
Development in Greater Reading on BCTV is supported by Fulton Bank.